attempt. Yeah, it's the Metro Mapper game, but it's the first chance for fans to play the game on a large scale. And eventually it went to open beta, accompanied with an awesome welcome to the open beta trailer. And all this did was simply spell out all of it. That you could do in the game. And I think that we need more trailers like this nowadays. I think people want that detail and information. They will watch it. As the launch of the game grew closer and BF3 was approaching the finish line, on October 18th, the new multiplayer shows multiple maps that we haven't seen before, mainly focusing on Damavand Peak and Noshar Canal. Hang on a second, you're telling me that that's multiplayer, and I can skydive off a helipad with my teammates as helicopters fly down next to me? I'm sold. It's a massive vertical level, which included tanks, Humvees, helicopters inside tunnels. What is this? Mission Impossible? Oh my god, I need to play this game. And more! Aircraft in Paris, it's all outside, same crossing. But there's water and bridges, and it's kind of wide open. Rubble drops, and there's that night map that we've seen before, and then quick glimpses of the rest of the map with wide panning shots. Perfect. Those classic the final trailer before it's go time. October 21st, the Battlefield 3 launch trailer. And honestly, I think that this is one of the best video game trailers ever released. Some of the transitions and the video content, it's all incredible. The audio is superb. Watch this and try not to want to play the idea of the game that pops into your head.
Shane, you come to our country to murder us, yet we are the terrorists.
Political, mature, violent, practical, epic games, IR scopes, the camaraderie. I think I watched that trailer around 50 times, and the final line of the video just stuck with me for ages. So the game launches on October 25th in North America, and then the rest of the world in the game had 3 million pre-orders. Within a week, it had shipped 10 million copies. And less than a year later, in June 2012, EA revealed that the game had sold over 15 million copies. And the rumors are that as of today, around 21 million copies of Battlefield 3 have been sold in total. And you know what? The successful marketing didn't stop there either. With each new DLC, there were solid teasers or trailers released. Each DLC pack had a theme, and you knew what? Motorbikes and colourful levels, and we didn't have the community test environment back then either, spoiling new content for the game. I know that its intended purpose is to test new content so it works on release, which is great, but a big negative side effect of this is you do lose the element of surprise and intrigue when new content drops. We haven't had those same feelings in BF4 since the CTE was released, and the same applied for BF1 too, maybe even. Undeniable that the hype for this game was very, very real, and that the marketing and trailer team really created intrigue, mystery, and what this game was going to be like. And that it was truly next gen, standing out from its peers. Every step of the way, there was always a tease, another carrot on a stick, and it just worked so well. Myself and many others will always have fond memories of Battlefield 3. There's absolutely no doubt about it. And I think a lot should be learnt from what DICE and EA did with the marketing and hype for this game. And that's all for today, folks. Let me know your thoughts.